Now this question, integration of 1 upon root a square minus x square dx. We have to think that how root a square minus x square come out the bracket. If you put this x equal to a sin theta, you will get dx equal to a cos theta d theta. So root of a square minus x square equal to square root of a square minus a square sine square theta. Now this a square taken out common and comes out the bracket square root. So this is equal to a square root of 1 minus sine square x, that is equal to a cos theta. A root 1 minus sine square theta equal to a cos theta. So your integration will be equal to, instead of dx you may put a cos theta d theta. And instead of root a square minus x square, this is also a cos theta. So a cos theta cancels in numerator and denominator. You will get integration of d theta, that is equal to theta plus c. Now if x equal to a sin theta, then sin theta will be x upon a. So theta equal to sin inverse x by a plus c. Your result is sin inverse x by a plus c. Now this is the question, integration of 1 upon x root x square minus a square dx. For the purpose, if you put x equal to a sec theta, then dx equal to a sec theta tan theta d theta. So this integral is equal to integration of a tan theta sec theta d theta whole upon, now x root x square minus a square. So x is a sec theta, and what will be root x square minus a square? That is root a square sec square theta minus a square. So that is equal to square root of a square under bracket sec square theta minus 1. That is square root of a square tan square theta is a tan theta. So the denominator becomes a sec theta into a tan theta. Now tan theta sec theta and a will cancel in numerator and denominator. You will get 1 upon a integration d theta. So this is equal to 1 upon a theta plus c, that is 1 upon a, but theta will be what? Here sec theta is x upon a. So a equal to sec inverse x upon a, this will be sec inverse x by a plus c.